Hi, this is Dr. Jim DuCanto. I'm an anesthesiologist from the United States, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. I'm here to demonstrate what is known as the S.A.L.A.D. technique. S.A.L.A.D. is an acronym for Suction-Assisted Laryngoscopy with Airway Decontamination. In the performance of this technique, we're going to be using a specially prepared mannequin that will express something akin to a gastrointestinal bleed with simulated airway contaminant. And as we see, I'm going to go ahead and turn on our HEINE Vision Pro, and I'm going to hold my suction in a manner that's very similar to the position of how I would hold a laryngoscope. I'm going to hold the distal tip of the suction tube going down and away. I'll begin this procedure simply by pushing on the chin and inserting the suction into the oral pharynx of the mannequin. As I decontaminate the oral pharynx, what I'm going to do next is I'm actually going to compress the tongue into the floor of the mouth and lift the tongue off the posterior pharyngeal wall. This is going to afford me the space to place my laryngoscope much more quickly and easily while keeping the optics as high as I can off of the posterior pharyngeal wall to minimize the risk of contaminating the lens of the laryngoscope. I'm seeing the epiglottis now on visualization. I'm going to expose the larynx. So this is an example of the airway being recontaminated. Now, if I take my suction out of the simulated patient, I can expect for the entire pharynx to fill up with airway contaminant. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave the suction in during the intubation without interfering with the path of tracheal tube delivery. I'm going to take the suction from the right side of the laryngoscope to the left side of the laryngoscope into the upper esophagus. What I will do now is I will expose the larynx and create space for the tracheal tube delivery with my index finger. I call this technique the S.A.L.A.D. poke. I'm entering the larynx. I'm going to turn the bougie tip of the fova posteriorly and go into the simulated lung. I'll go ahead and place my tracheal tube now, and I don't have an assistant, so I'll just do this on my own. And as I advance the tracheal tube, there's a potential for hang-up of the tracheal tube on the larynx. I will put a leftward counterclockwise twist into the tracheal tube as I advance the tracheal tube to minimize the gap between the leading edge of the left cut bevel of the tracheal tube and the bougie itself. I'll go ahead and remove my bougie, place it, and inflate the cuff, and ventilate the patient. I see that I've avoided failure of tracheal tube delivery in a soiled airway, and I have visual confirmation of tracheal tube delivery to the larynx instead of the esophagus. As I've been able to contain a severely soiled airway with a technique with a MAC-shaped video laryngoscope, it's given me several different layers of utility and safety during the procedure. Number one is that it's able to compress the tongue into the floor of the mouth adequately to allow visualization under direct as well as video laryngoscopy. Number two, should it become soiled, I can use the direct laryngoscopy feature immediately. And number three, should everything become soiled, I can switch these blades out at a moment's notice, provided, of course, I have ample supplies of disposables, which are affordably priced, so there will be no reason why that isn't the case. What we have demonstrated here also with the use of suction is how to continually remove airway contaminants, which either can come from the upper GI tract into the hypopharynx, or from the nasopharynx or base of tongue coming down the posterior pharyngeal wall, or pulmonary edema. In those cases, the suction would not be placed so deeply into the esophagus, it would be placed immediately above the larynx.